After 4 years of occupation of nearly one-third of Croatian territory, life in exile or in eternal fear from enemies' retaliation, shells that threatened night and day, any unsuccessful negotiations and initiatives, there was nothing left for Croatia except to liberate by its own armed force what had always been hers. Croatian army grew into a force that could do that by itself without anybody's help. The time for storm came on 4th of August in 1995. Five minutes for memory. The military operation Storm. After initial operations of the CAF and destroyed enemy signal systems and artillery preparation in line, the designated military targets, Croatian forces proceeded with the action that was conducted concurrently from 30 directions on the battlefield 700 kilometers long. The striking force on the main attack directions was formed by guard brigades supported by special police of the Ministry of the Interior and Croatian Guards Corps, Home Guards and Reserve Units. That was, in tactical and strategic terms, a military operation that will be studied by many military analysts owing to its originality and level of success. Main directions of the attack were from the mountains Dinara and Velebit in the direction of Knin. Preconditions were already created in the operation Summer 95 for the 4th and 7th Guards Brigade to move from the peaks of Dinara towards Knin. On the other side, from Velebit through Sveti Rok, special units of the Ministry of the Interior advanced towards Knin. The 1st Guards Corps entered the depth of the enemy's background by helicopter assault. The mission of the 9th Guards Brigade was to conquer the pass Ljubovo and neutralize the enemy's air base at Udbina. North of the Kapela area, through Slunj and Rakovica from one side and Korenica and Plitvice from the other side, forces of the 1st Guards Brigade advanced with objective to join the 5th Corps of the Army of Bosnia and Herzegovina. The area of Banija was encircled from several directions. The striking force in the direction of Petrinja, where the enemy put up a fierce fight, and further towards Glina, was the 2nd Guards Brigade. During that time, units of the 3rd and 5th Guards Brigade were in state of alert in the far east of Croatia, in case of possible movements of the enemy. During the first day of the operation, the push of the Croatian army units in depth was from 5 to 15 kilometers, and the enemy's strongholds were brought in encirclement or semi-encirclement. 80% of the planned combat missions were already executed on the second day. Most of the occupied Croatian towns are free again. Kostanica, Petrinja, Glina, Slunj, Gračac, Obrovac, Drniš celebrate. Triumph is also in the symbol of the enemy's mutiny, in the Croatian royal town Knin. The entire Croatia celebrates. With the liberation of Knin, the center of enemy's mutiny in Croatia, the most important strategic political goal was achieved, not only for the Operation Storm, but of the entire homeland war. Only a few days later, in the northern part of the battlefield as well, the enemy forces of the 21st Cordon Corps were forced to sign capitulation. In only 84 hours of the military constabulary Operation Storm, in which almost 200,000 Croatian soldiers took part and more than 10,000 square kilometers of the till then occupied territory were liberated, the Croatian army accomplished all targeted objectives. Nobody except us believed it was possible to achieve them. Town squares were too narrow for all those people who wanted to greet the winners. Pride, enthusiasm, fellowship, smile, and tears of joy were never so big, deeper, and more sincere than in those days. The days after which nothing will be the same.